One of the most beautiful sites that we look forward to visiting on the Douro cruise is the city of Salamanca in Spain. It's a gorgeous medieval city and has a very rich Jewish history, particularly for the first half of the millennium of the Common Era. Here's a map that shows you where Salamanca is. It's actually not on the Douro itself, so we have to take a bus to get there, but a very short bus ride. It will be a very significant city for the Douro, however, because when the Jews would be expelled from Salamanca, many of them would make their way directly to Portugal along the Douro River Valley. The earliest documentation of Jews in Salamanca dates to the 12th century, and it's interesting to note that from its inception, it appears that the Jews actually had fairly strong civil rights in the town. These would be degraded over the next few hundred years, but for example, under Fernando II, who reigned in the middle of the 12th century, Jews were given equal judicial rights as Christians in the town, and this is something which was repeated later in the 13th century when a charter, a fuero, was granted to the Jewish community there. They were given full legal rights and also a lot of privileges to judge themselves by Talmudic law. There were some exceptions. If Jews and Christians were involved in a lawsuit, then that might have to go to Christian judges. But otherwise, the Jews had a very strong level of self-government. There were still some discriminatory taxes in place that were specifically connected to the Jewish community. But on the whole, for the earlier period in particular, the Jews actually did very well. We know that by the 13th century, the Jews in Salamanca actually had three synagogues, the so-called Vieja, or the Old Synagogue, the Nueva, the New Synagogue, and the Menor, which means the Small Synagogue. This was actually much of an improvement over many other Jewish communities in Europe, because the custom was, of course, to only have two synagogues, one that you would pray in, and one that you wouldn't be caught dead in. So in the 14th century, you begin to see a decline in the quality of life for the Jews in Salamanca. There's growing intolerance. In the year 1335, new laws are passed to say that Christians could not seek medical services from Jews, which must have been a hardship on the population because Jews are very traditionally associated with medicine, particularly in Spain. This is the place where, after all, Maimonides comes from, a little bit south of Salamanca, but nevertheless. Also, there are the beginnings of residency restrictions where Jews are not allowed to live in certain areas and are encouraged to live in other areas, but you know, this is really not so much of a hardship because Jews generally are quite gregarious. They like to stick with one another. They have to live within walking distance of a synagogue, of a ritual bath, of an Asian restaurant, things like that. Unfortunately, towards the end of the 14th century, you see some more significant attacks. Salamanca is largely spared the wave of pogroms that washes across Spain in the year 1391. These are pogroms that are accompanied by some forced baptisms that would have a long-lasting impact on the Jews of Spain because it ironically created a new class of citizen in Spain, these so-called new Christians, that is, Jews who were forcibly converted to Christianity, who retained all of their personal identification with Judaism and the Jewish community, but at the same time had the freedom, movement, and privilege of Christians. And this created a rather untenable situation, especially for the church in the 14th century, which will ultimately result in the Inquisition and later the expulsion of Jews. One of the most beautiful areas of Salamanca, in my humble opinion, is the gorgeous medieval university that exists there. And Jews have had a long association with this particular school, especially from the 14th century on. Not only in terms of contributing to its intellectual heft, as many Jews, especially after the forced conversions, would participate in teaching at the University of Salamanca, but also in a very material way. Their Beit Midrash, for example, the Jewish study hall, was ended up, you know, being confiscated by the university when Juan II donated it in 1413. This is after the wave of conversions that occurred following the 1391 pogroms across the Iberian Peninsula. It ended up becoming a dormitory. But even afterwards, Jews, now conversos or new Christians, are still participating very actively in the university life. they would come under significant pressure during the period of the Inquisition, beginning from the 1470s and on, but they were deeply embedded in the intellectual life of the university. As you can see, that here's a couple of pictures from the last time I was there with Kosher River Cruises. You know, Hebrew was an extremely important element of the curriculum, especially the theological part of the school. Here's actually a picture of me in the one of the lecture halls there, which is really quite fascinating. I really enjoyed the classroom furniture. Check out these benches here. No one is falling asleep in my class if I get to lecture in a room like this. Unfortunately, the story of the Jews of Salamanca in the 15th century comes to a dramatic and sad ending with the expulsion of the Jews from Spain in 1492. The synagogue is confiscated by the church and given over to become a private residence, and the Jews who were conversos are now subject to significant persecution by the Inquisition. Those Jews who were never forcibly baptized to Christianity or who had never elected to become Christians decided that Portugal was one of the best places for them to go, and they made their way across the border. Here, by the way, is a dramatic representation of the presentation of the idea of expulsion to Isabella and Ferdinand, the king and queen, and the person wildly gesticulating wearing the black is none other than the Grand Inquisitor Torquemada himself, and standing with his back to the viewer is Don Isaac Abravanel, very important rabbi and social activist politician of that era. The art is by Emilio Salo, painted in 1889. Okay, I hope that you will be able to join us on this amazing cruise along the Douro River, and I'm especially looking forward to seeing Salamanca again with you. Thank you very much for watching.